Christians persecuting other Christians. Many Christians suffer persecutions in their daily walk with Christ. This should not be surprising. Jesus predicted it for those who believed in him, John 15:20, and the Apostle Peter told the church that they should not be surprised when they suffer insults because of their faith in Christ, 1 Peter 4:14. What is surprising is that other Christians receive persecutions and some of the fiercest at that from other Christians. This ought not to be so. We are told to put on the whole armor of God and to protect ourselves from spiritual attacks, Ephesians 6:10-18. The only offensive weapon mentioned is the sword, which is the word of God. This weapon is intended to fight off spiritual attacks from wicked spirits, but all too often believers wield this weapon against other Christians. However, this is not the intended use for this weapon. The last thing that Christ would have us to do is to attack other Christians using the Word of God, Bible. Yes, we should challenge false teachings and false gospels when we see them, and the Bible tells us that there will be many of these in the last days, but we are not to attack each other over non-essentials. When Christians fight with each other over things that are not central to the gospel of Jesus Christ, Calvary, Jesus' atoning sacrifice, etc., then we send a strong message to unbelievers that we cannot even get along with each other. Where is Christ in that? Some Christians go so far as to sue one another in a court of law. This grieves God greatly. The Corinthian church was so carnal that they were fighting and arguing over who had the best spiritual gifts, even though these gifts were from God and not gifts that they themselves had developed. They were suing each other too, as Paul angrily stated in 1 Corinthians 6:5-6, "I say this to shame you. Is it possible that there is nobody among you wise enough to judge a dispute between believers? But instead, one brother takes another to court, and this in front of unbelievers. By doing this in full view of non-believers, we shame the reputation of Christ. We are redeemed, but many times we don't live like the redeemed and we don't reflect the Redeemer." Paul battled with the carnal Corinthians who felt superior to each other over gifts and over knowledge. Paul knew considerably more than they did, but he did not flaunt it over them. Paul said, "We know that we all possess knowledge. But knowledge puffs up while love builds up. Those who think they know something do not yet know as they ought to know," 1 Corinthians 8:1-2. Pride was the cause of Satan's fall. He was lifted up and wanted to be over God himself. Pride is essentially at the root of all sin. God resists the proud, but he gives grace to the humble. Literally, God opposes the proud but shows favor to the humble, James 4:6, Proverbs 3:34. He who is not against us is for us. Jesus saw some petty jealousies even in his day. His disciples came and told Jesus that others were teaching and preaching in his name. They approached Jesus with the attitude of, "How dare they?" Jesus said, "Do not hinder him, for he who is not against you is for you," Luke 9:50. Aren't we really on the same side? Don't we all need to get along? Instead, we fight over peripheral issues that are not essential to salvation. I heard it put this way: the main thing is to keep the main thing, the main thing. That should be Jesus Christ and him crucified. Paul boasted to know nothing else by Jesus Christ and him crucified, 1 Corinthians 2:2. Some argue that unless you have spoken in tongues, you have not been truly filled with the Spirit. Others believe that anyone who doesn't believe in the rapture is wrong. Still others believe in healing ministries today, while others disagree. Some churches believe in tithing, others don't. Some believe it is wrong to eat pork, others disagree. Some worship on Saturday while others worship on Sunday. Some believe in the millennium while others do not. Love one another. Jesus said that a house divided cannot stand, and Christians are sometimes divided over issues that are not central to Calvary. The body of Christ should not be divided against itself, yet many times we are attacking each other over beliefs or any belief that differs from ours. I love to quote the saying, "In essentials unity, in non-essentials liberty, in all things charity." This means that above all things should be love. We all have differences, yet these differences should not make us divided, they should make us complete. Paul spoke about the gifts of the Spirit and said that the hand cannot say to the foot that I have no need for you, or the eye cannot tell the ear that you are not needed. No, we all need each other. We should be praying for one another. Paul wrote in 1 Corinthians 12:25 that there should be no division in the body, but that its parts should have equal concern for each other. Jesus told us that the world would know us if we loved one another, not if we argued against each other. John 13:35. That is exactly what Satan must delight in. What would Christ say to us if he returned to see that we are fighting over issues that are not essential to our own salvation, and to tell others about Christ for the Great Commission? I think he would honestly be ashamed of us, or worse.